Okay, so let's see. It's still going on. It will take some 2 to 3 minutes depending upon your net speed and whether you are doing it for the first time or so. At the end of the operation, you will be having some HTML page, something like this, which will show you the various vulnerabilities it has found through that particular testing phase. You can see in this particular URL which I had provided, it is having approximately 9 SQL injection vulnerabilities, 8 blind SQL injection attacks possible, 1 file handling vulnerability, and 15 cross-site scripting vulnerability present. So obviously, such kind of a vulnerability, if you are having in your website, it's not even liable to be published. It's not even liable to be hosted with such a number of vulnerability. But the thing is, this particular website is nothing but a test website. So what we can see is these vulnerabilities are intentionally left so you can carry out the attacks and find out whether it is vulnerable or not. It's such straightforward, such simple. Okay, so let's click on this particular vulnerability. You can see SQL injection is having this particular website is having 9 SQL injection attacks possible. So let's see the very first attack or very first URL where it is having a vulnerability. It's something like this, artist.php. You can click over here, you will get the actual URL which is causing the vulnerability. If you just copy it and paste it in your taskbar, address bar, you can see actually where the vulnerability lies. Now we all know what is SQL injection. SQL injection is nothing but whenever we are capable of directly interacting with the database of a particular web application, then we come to a position that we come to a scenario where we can directly issue SQL commands to the web server database. That is not a desirable case, because in such a case, what can happen is any attacker can get access to your useful information or credentials stored at the back end. You can see in this particular URL, this sort of a warning is shown to me. This is not at all desirable, because from this statement I can make out that line number 62 is something which is throwing an error, which is nothing but an SQL error. So these sort of errors should not be shown anywhere on your website. If such kind of an error is shown, it means that your website is prone to SQL injection and you should take immediate steps to rectify those. Okay, so similarly, we can see n number of pages over here which are having the various vulnerabilities, blind SQL injection attack, file handling attacks, and so on. So let's go back to our page. It's still working out, it's still happening. It will take some time. So let me pause the video for some time and we'll get back to it as soon as it is complete. Okay, so after a while, approximately 2 to 3 minutes have passed. At the end, what I am having is, you can see a report has been generated in the file so and so location. So get back to that location. I'm already here. See, this sort of a file will be created. When you click on it, it will jump to that particular web page which I was just now showing you. Okay, so you can see the same contents. The contents are same, unchanged. It is having the same number of vulnerabilities in SQL injection, that is 9, and so on. So at the end, if you are a website security assessment officer, or in short, if you are destined, or if you are chosen to perform security audits of a particular web application or any application in for that matter, so it's your main task to go through that website, find out the various loopholes, find out the various vulnerabilities present in your website, and create an audit report. So this is how an audit report can be created for a particular website using the tool Wapiti. So for simplicity purpose, we are using this particular URL. If you are getting bored of this particular URL, what you can do is, you can simply search on Google vulnerable websites for testing or for hacking. You will come across n number of websites on which you can practice your hacking skills. For example, this particular site is having 40 plus intentionally vulnerable websites for your hacking purpose, for your hacking skills. So you can select any such particular website and carry out your particular attack. In case you're having any issues with the contents we have discussed so far, you can surely get back to me through the comment section. I will definitely solve your queries over there. That's it for today in the Wapiti experiment number 4. I'm sure you're enjoying the series so far. If you're having any such suggestions or comments for me to improve my content, I'm more than welcome to hear you. Thank you so much. Do like, subscribe, and share to my channel.